I am sitting in the morning at the diner on the corner. I am waiting at the counter for the man to pour the coffee. And he fills it only halfway. And before I even argue, he is looking out the window at somebody coming in. It is always nice to see you, says the man behind the counter to the woman who has come in. She is shaking her umbrella, and I look the other way as they are kissing their hellos, and I'm pretending not to see them, and instead I pour the milk. I open up the paper, there's a story of an actor who had died while he was drinking. It was no one I had heard of, and I'm turning to the horoscope and looking for the funnies when I'm feeling someone watching me, and so I raise my head. There's a woman on the outside looking inside. Does she see me? No, she does not really see me, 'cause she sees her own reflection. And I'm trying not to notice that she's hitching up her skirt, and while she's straightening her stockings, her hair has gotten wet. Oh, this rain, it will continue through the morning as I'm listening to the bells of the cathedral. I am thinking of your voice and of the midnight picnic once upon a time before the rain began. And I finish up my coffee and it's time to catch the train. So I have this friend, Brian, and he's a photographer. And he said to me one night that he felt that he saw his life as though he were seeing it through a pane of glass. So that he felt that he was always witnessing things and never really involved in them, which I thought was interesting. So the next morning when I was having breakfast at Tom's Diner, I was thinking to myself, how would Brian see the situation? You come from far away with pictures in your eyes of coffee shops and morning streets in the blue and silent sunrise. But night is the cathedral where we recognize the sign. We strangers know each other now as part of the whole design. Hold me like a baby that will not fall asleep. Curl me up inside you and let me hear you through the heat. Oh, you're the jester of this courtyard with a smile like a girl's, distracted by the women with the dimples and the curls, by the pretty and the mischievous, by the timid and the blessed, by the blowing skirts of ladies who promise to gather you to their breast. Hold me like a baby that curl me up inside you and let me hear you through the heat. Oh, you have hands of rain and water. Wisdom on your face denies the number of your years. With the fingers of the potter, and the laughing tale of the fool, the arranger of disorder with your strange and simple rules. Yeah, now I've made me another spinner of strange and gauzy threads, with a long and slender body and a bump upon the head. Oh, hold me like a baby that will not fall asleep. Curl me up inside you and let me hear you through the heat. Oh, with a long and slender body and the sweetest, softest hands, and we'll blow away forever soon and go on to different lands. And please do not ever look for me, but with me you will stay. And you will hear yourself in song blowing by one day. But now hold me like a baby that will not fall asleep. Curl me up inside you and let me hear you through the heat. Oh, my name is Luca. I live on the second floor. I live upstairs from you. Yes, I think you've seen me before. If you hear something late at night, some kind of trouble, some kind of fright, just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. I think it's 'cause I'm clumsy. I try not to talk too loud. Maybe it's because I'm crazy. I try not to act too proud. And they only hit until you cry. After that, you don't ask why. You just don't argue. Just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore. Yes, I think I'm okay. I walked in through the door again. If you ask, that's what I'll say. And it's not your business anyway. I guess I'd like to be alone with nothing broken, nothing thrown. Just don't ask me how I am. Just don't ask me how I am. Just don't ask me how I am. My name is Luca. I live on the second floor. I live upstairs from you. Yes, I think you've seen me before. If you hear something late at night, some kind of trouble, some kind of fright, just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Only hit until you cry. And after that, you don't ask why. Just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore. A few years ago, I used to see this group of children playing in front of my building, and there was one of them whose name was Luca, who seemed a little bit distinctive from the other children. I always remembered his name, and I always remembered his face, and I didn't know very much about him, but he just seemed set apart from these other children that I would see playing. And I guess his character is what I based the song Luca on. In the song, the boy Luca is an abused child. In real life, I don't think he was. I think he was just different. So this song is called Freeze Tag. And Freeze Tag is a game that I used to play in third grade. And it's a form of tag where you touch someone and they freeze. And they can't move again until you touch them again, and then they can run around as they were running before. So this song is about, it's called Freeze Tag, and it's about other kinds of games that you play when you get older. Time. The sun is fading fast upon the slides into the past, upon the swings of indecision in the wintertime, in the dimming diamonds scattering in the park, in the tickling and the trembling of freeze tag in the dark. We play that we're actors on a movie screen. I will be Dietrich and you can be Dean. You stand with your hand in your pocket and lean against the wall. You will be Bogart and I will be Bacall. And we can only say yes now to the sky, to the street, to the night. Slow fade now to black. Play me one more game of chivalry. You and me, do you see where I've been hiding in this hide and seek? And we go to the playground in the wintertime. The sun is fading fast upon the slides into the past, upon the swings of indecision in the wintertime, 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 wintertime. We can only say yes now to the sky, to the street, to the night. We can only say yes now to the sky, to the street, to the night. Thank you. solitude stands by the window. She turns her head as I walk in the room. I can see by her eyes she's been waiting. Standing in the slant of the late afternoon, and she turns to me with her hand extended. Her palm is split with a flower with a flame. Again by a black silhouette, by a long cool stare and her silence. I suddenly remember each time we've met, and she turns to me with her hand extended. Her palm is split with a flower with a flame. She says, I've come to lighten this dark heart. And she takes my wrist, I feel her imprint of fear. And I said, I never thought of finding you here. And I turn to the crowd as they watch. They're sitting all together in the dark and the warm, and I wanted to be in there. Their eyes are gathered into one, and then she turns to me with her hand extended. Her palm is split with a flower with a flame. Set a twisted then straight, and she says, I've come to lighten this dark heart. And she takes my wrist, I feel her imprint of fear. And I said, I never thought of finding you here. Solitude stands in the doorway. I'm struck once again by her black silhouette, by her long cool stare and her silence. I suddenly remember each time we've met, and she turns to me with her hand extended. Her palm is split with a flower with a flame.
It occurred to me that if solitude were a person, I thought she would be a woman. And I thought it would be a woman standing by a window. And the more I thought about this as an idea of solitude being a person, I thought that sometimes solitude appears as a third character in relationships. Say, if there's two people together, sometimes you can feel that solitude appears and tries to pull one of them away. And I started to think about the character of this person. What sort of character would it be? Would it be a friendly character? Would it be threatening? And I decided it would be a little bit of both, that it would have some kind of authority, but still be somewhat friendly, but still something that you had to beware of a little bit. And to me, there was also something that seemed motherly in this character. And there was another song I wrote about the same time, which also had a sort of motherly figure in it, which was Night Vision, was written from the point of view of a mother singing to a child before the child falls asleep. But it's also, Night Vision is also a song about trying to find your way in the dark, trying to find your vision when things are cloudy or, you know, blurry. It's also a song about creating something new. And in a sense, for me, it was a song about the album and my struggling to create songs from nothing, you know, which I guess is what you're always trying to do when you create something new.
By day, give thanks. By night, beware. Half the world in sweetness, the other in fear. When the darkness takes you with her hand across your face, don't give in too quickly. Find the thing she's erased. Find the line, find the shape through the grain. Find the outline and things will tell you their name. The table, the guitar, the empty glass. Find the line, find the shape through the grain. Find the outline and things will tell you their name. Now I watch you falling into sleep. Watch your fist uncurl against the sheet. Watch your lips fall.